Hey, what's up? It's me, Jessica J, and today I'm going to talk about a recurring theme I've seen with a lot of my clients. I actually am just now wrapping up my Spotlight Speed Dating program. I'm graduating a few guys out where guys can come on a call with me and my girlfriends, a Zoom call, and they basically just practice talking to women while I watch and critique them along the way. So with a lot of spots opening up right now, if this is something that you know you could use to further help you along to get and keep the women you want, don't forget to apply at speaktosparkarousal.com/PPD. So this recurring theme has to do with a lot of guys coming on and wanting to know, Jessica, what am I doing wrong? And you know, these guys come on the call, they've got these stories where it's difficult for them to approach women, it's difficult for them to get a connection going, get a conversation going, get a good engagement, and create chemistry. But here's the thing, one of my favorite shows is My 600 Pound Life. And I'll tell you right now, all of these motherfuckers, I don't wanna call them motherfuckers, but all of these people on this show, again, are over 600 pounds. They're not going out and approaching people, but all of them are finding love. All of them are in love or, you know, dating and shit. So how is it that people who literally cannot function in society are still capable of finding love? And really, it just boils down to we're not meant to connect with 99.9% of the people out there. However, while that is something I always say, we are not meant to connect with, my question then becomes, well, are you even connecting with people? Because the running theme in this whole Spotlight Speed Dating program is generally that all my girlfriends, you know, they start off, they meet these guys week one, and it's like, oh, bless him. Oh. And then by week four, after we're spending all this time together, all my girlfriends are sitting there trying to fuck these dudes. Granted, it's not like we're spending quality time with these dudes. It's not like they're actually going on a real date. It's not like they're actually talking to and connecting with one another. But something else is happening. What we're doing is we're getting to know these guys. In fact, I just got off a call and my girlfriend was saying to one of the guys, yeah, if I saw you on Tinder, if I saw you on the street, you wouldn't be my type. But now that I've gotten to know you, I am absolutely attracted to you. And then we got off the call and she was like, I would absolutely fuck him if you could set that up. So here's the thing. While there's nothing wrong with you, if you're not getting and keeping the women you want, you are absolutely doing something wrong. Again, we're all capable of finding somebody to love us for the person we are right now. However, if the people or the women you want right now are not wanting you, chances are they're not getting to know you for who you are. Now, so many guys are like, but Jessica, they're not giving me the chance to show them who I really am. And to that, I say actions speak louder than words. If you are not being yourself, trying to spend time doing this is not going to help the cause. And we women nowadays, we are so much more closed off. Ever since the pandemic, ever since the Me Too movement, we don't want fuck all to do with you guys out in public. But you wanna know what we do want in public? We want a connection. We want somebody that'll make us feel so emotionally compelled to chase after you that it doesn't matter that there was a Me Too movement or that there was a pandemic. All that matters is how we can make you ours. But here's the worst part. All the advice out there is like, be yourself, ha! But it's like, how the fuck do you do that? Who the fuck are you even? I'll tell you right now, who you are is who you are in this moment with your thoughts, your feelings, and your experiences, and showing that to women immediately. Again, the call I just got off of, I was sitting here telling this dude, stop talking about shit that doesn't matter. You're talking about all these abstract concepts like, oh yeah, people generally are like this. Oh yeah, you should do this and you should do that. No, I wanna know who the fuck you are. So if you know that you're a great fucking guy, there's actually nothing wrong with you, but you might be doing something wrong, I invite you to apply to my Spotlight Speed Dating program where we will get on a fucking call and I will tell you exactly what it is you are doing wrong, because I promise you, once a woman gets to know you for who you really are, which can happen in a matter of seconds, once you start showing us who you really are, you will absolutely get women that you want for yourself. And you'll have your pick of them all, because women rarely get to see a guy for who he is because most guys don't know how to show it. So this is your opportunity to jump ahead of the line with all the guys out there trying to get the women you want. Apply now with Spotlight Speed Dating. speaksparkarousal.com/PPD. Thanks for watching as always, and please realize that you are a great motherfucker and you're not going to connect with 99.9% of the people out there. And if you know you need help learning how to connect so you can get and keep the women you want, please apply to my program. I promise you, you'll have a great time and you will finally stop doing the shit keeping you from who and what you want. All right, I'm done. Thanks for watching. See you guys next time.